Today I want to talk about t-tests and ANOVA and show that they can all be done in regression. So what I want to show is first how to do an independent t-test, then a dependent t-test, then an ANOVA, and show how they can all be done as regression. So my conclusions will be why you worry about their individual assumptions if we can just worry about their regression assumptions. So t-test asks if two groups differ, and the independent variable is a category group membership variable, and the dependent variable must be continuous. So for this analysis, we're going to look at whether surfers front the vowel oo more than non-surfers, and it's made-up data. The dependent variable is the F2 of oo, and the independent variable is surfer versus non-surfer, and this is what the spreadsheet looks like. To do this in Jamovi, choose t-test, independent samples t-test, and put the variables in as shown below. And what we see is that the group difference is significant. And when we look at the means, we see that the non-surfers have a lower F2 than the surfers do. I'm not going to go into the assumptions of a t-test, but let's look at a dependent t-test, often called a paired t-test, and it's used when the same things have been measured twice. A common use of a paired t-test is compare the score of a test before a treatment and the score after the treatment. In this case, each row represents a subject, and there's one column for the before and one column for the after scores. To do this in Jamovi, choose t-test, paired samples t-test, and put both variables in the right-hand box. What we see is that the difference is significant, and when we look at the means, the after score is larger than the before score. ANOVA tests if there are differences between two or more groups, and once again I'll use made-up data. And the question is, do native speakers of different language groups perform differently on a TESOL test? So we have Germanic, Asian, and other European groups. To do an ANOVA in Jamovi, choose ANOVA, one-way ANOVA, and in the post-hoc test, move native language to the right box. Here are the results we get. Native language is significant, but what we don't know is which groups are significant from each other until we look at the results of the post-hoc. And what we see is that the other European group is significantly different from the other two groups. Once again, I'm not going to discuss the assumptions. Now let's look at how we can do a t-test as regression. So choose regression, linear regression, put the variables in, and these are the results of the regression. What we see is that the results are identical. Now let's look at a paired t-test as regression. Now in this case, the data must be arranged a little bit. In a paired t-test, each score appears in its own column. But in a regression, there's only one column for score and another variable must be added that indicates whether the test was before or after. To do this in Jamovi, choose linear models, mixed models. If linear models isn't an option, you need to install the GAMLJ module. Put in participant as a random effect since participants give more than one measure. The results of our mixed effects regression are significant. Just as the paired t-test, they give us an F-score of 10.1, which is different from the t-score of -3.07, but what we need to realize is that if we square the t-statistic, we get the F-statistic. The results are the same. How about running an ANOVA as regression? Choose regression, linear regression. Set the reference level to other European. Here are the regression results, and what's nice about it is it gives us the comparisons already. It shows that other European is significantly different from German, and other European is also significantly different from Asian. The same differences are found as in the ANOVA. So here's my conclusion. If we can get the same results in regression as in t-tests and ANOVA, why not just do regression? That way we only have to worry about the assumptions of regression, not the assumptions of ANOVAs and t-tests.